Okay, so how to calculate L? L is equal to 2 times 10 minus 7 ln GMD over GMR. Henry per meter. Okay, you can use this equation or you can use 0.2 ln GMD over GMR milli Henry per kilometer. So you also can use this equation lah. Okay. So what you have to do is you have to calculate GMD and GMR. So what is GMD? For three-phase double circuit transmission line with bundle of two. What is GMD and what is GMR? Okay. So can you calculate GMD and GMR? Any problem you face in order to calculate GMD and GMR? Okay. So based on this question, okay, so this is a three-phase double circuit with a bundle of two. Why bundle of two? Because they have two conductors for every phases. Let's say this phase A, this A2, they have two sub conductors which hang beside each other lah. Okay, this phase A, phase A2, phase B, they have two conductor. C also have two conductors. Okay, that means this is three-phase double circuit with a bundle of two. Okay, so now we have to calculate GMD and GMR. What is GMD? Okay, how to calculate GMD? So based on the file that I gave you last week, this is the equation how to calculate GMD and GMR. So can you see this file? Can you see this equation? Anyone?
Boleh, sir.
Boleh, ya? Okay. So, based on this equation, actually you can solve the problem lah. Okay, so for that question, we want to calculate inductance per kilometer. Okay, so the question is, analyze the inductance and capacitance per kilometer. Inductance per phase per kilometer. So L for 1 km and C for 1 km lah. Okay. So based on this equation, what you have to do is you have to calculate GMD and GMR. So GMD is given by this equation, okay, same as GMR. Okay, so first we have to calculate GMD. So based on this circuit, okay, how to calculate GMD? This equation, we can use this equation, equation number one. Let's say this is one number one, to calculate inductance per meter. So or you can use this equation to calculate inductance per kilometer lah. Okay, this one per meter, this one per kilometer. You can use either one. So first you have to calculate D between A and B, D between B and C, D between C and A. Okay. Why you want to calculate this one? Because we want to calculate GMD. Metric mean distance, that mean distance between these three cables A, B, B, C and C, A is equal to cube root of D, A, B, D, B, C, D, C, A. So what is D, A, B? Actually, you can derive this equation. DAB, that's mean DA1B1 DA2B1 DA2B2. Okay, this DAB. Same goes to DBC and DCA. If you don't know how to derive, you can look at the equations given. Okay, this is the given equation. The DAB, DBC or DCA is given in this appendix. Okay, DAB, that's mean DA to B. A to B, they have four distances. If you look at this this picture, so DAB, that's mean this one A, A1 to B1. How to find this one? The A to B, just take this central point, A1 to B1. This is the distance between A1 to B1. How to calculate this one? So you have to use theorem Pythagoras. Okay, so DA1 equal to square root of this distance. Okay, this distance. This is 10 meter square plus this distance. So this, let's say this x, how to find x? Okay, this x, how to calculate this x? This is a central point. So distance from here to this point is half of 24, that's mean 12 meter. Distance from here to this point is 8 meter. So distance x equal to 12 minus 8. That's mean 4 meter. Okay. So DAB, A1, B1, this distance, A1, B1, equal to 10 square, this distance, D, 10 square plus x is 4 square. So you will get the answer now. Okay. Okay. So you supposed to get this value. So DA1 B1 is equal to 10.7703 lah. Okay. So the rest you have to do the same. You have to calculate D B1 C1. Let's say how to calculate D B1 C1. B1, this B1, this center point of B1, C1 is down here. So we have this distance is 9 meter. This distance you have to calculate, let's say this is x. So this is the B1, C1. Okay. So you have to find x value lah. What is x? X actually equal to 12. This meter is 12, right? This meter is 12. X is equal to 12 minus 9. This 12 minus this point. This point is actually 8.5. Half of 17 is 8.5. So minus 8.5, you will get 3.5. That's why distance between B1, C1 equal to square root of 9 square plus 3.5 square. Okay. That's why we get this value lah. This x is 3.5. So we get this value. 9.6566. Okay, this DB1C1 and so on lah until we have all the distances. So why we have to calculate this one? Because we want to use these distances to calculate GMD. Okay, now we want to calculate GMD. And D, B1C1, D, B1C2, D, B2C1, D, B2C2. Okay, same goes to this DCA lah. Okay, we have to calculate these four distances. Then finally, you use all these distances inside this equation to calculate GMD. Okay. In this subtopic, actually, the difficulties is come from to find these distances. So mathematical analysis, more on mathematical equation. You have to calculate DAB, DCA, and DBC. Okay. When you have all these parameter, then you can solve GMD. Okay. So if you look at this, look at this, we can find all the distances. Then after that, we have to find the this one. Okay, GMD. So by calculating DAB, DBC, and DCA, we just put in this equation, so we get this GMD value 17.0887. Okay, so straightforward to calculate GMD. So until here, there is any problem? There is any question from student? Okay or not? If don't have question, I assume all of you understand. Okay. So now we have calculate the value of GMD. Okay, then we have to calculate GMR, geometric mean radius. So now we have to calculate GMR. So how to calculate GMR? So GMR, geometric mean radius for this particular circuit, is equal to cube root of DSA, DSB, and DSC. So you have to calculate DSA. Okay, DSA equal to DS bundle, right? Times D A1 A2. Okay. So DSA, DS bundle, this one, DS bundle. So in test of final exam, the equation will be given like this. So you have to understand. So DSA actually come from this equation. So from this equation, we can simplify into this equation, to this equation. So square root of DSB A1 A2. So what is the A1 A2? So we have DS given in the question. So GMR is given. This is GMR 1.7374 meter. A centimeter. This is actually DS. GMR is DS. But DS for one conductor. It's not for composite. It's not for bundle. So we have to calculate DS for bundle. So DS bundle equal to this bundle of two. BUND bundle of two. So bundle of two equal to DS times DA. A1, sorry. If you look at this equation, we have this is bundle of 2 times d ds times d. This bundle of 3 ds times d square, cube root of ds times d square. This bundle of 4, 1.09, the root of 4 ds times d, the power of 3. Okay. So, right? Okay, this one. So bundle of 2, this is not DA, sorry. This D. So times D. So this D is this displacement between these two cable. We have bundle of 2. This displacement is D. In this space A1, we have two cables. This displacement is 45 cm. Okay. So the bundle spacing is 45 cm. So this is D. So we just put this D in this equation. So we will get square root of DS 1.7374 cm times 45 cm. So you will get the value of DS. Okay. So so DS bundles is given by this value lah. When you calculate DS bundle, you will get this value. Okay. Okay. So when you get DS bundles, just put DS bundle into this equation to calculate DSA, DSB, and DSC lah. Okay, so we have DSA using this equation. So when you have this DS bundle, just put in this equation. This DA1, A2 is distance between this point to A2. Where is A2? Okay, here. In this case, DA1, A2 is 16. So DB1, B2 is equal to 24, equal to 24. C1, C2 equal to 17. Okay, just take these three values, put in the equation, this equation. So B, S, B equal to DS bundle times D B1 B2. Okay. Same goes to DSC equal to square root of DS bundle times DC1 C2. Okay. Calculate all these parameters, you will get this answer. Okay. DSA, you got this value, DSB, this value, and DSC, you got this value lah. Okay, so then you calculate GMRL. GMRL is equal to cube root of DSA, DSB, DSC lah. Then you will get this value. When you get GMD and GMR, you can calculate the value of inductance lah. Okay. So you can use this equation, this inductance per kilometer in millihenry per kilometer. Okay, So when you have value, then you can use the general equation to calculate L. Okay. So that's all for inductance. So any question? Soalan nak? Ada tak faham kat mana-mana ke? Soalan?
Tak ada.
Okay, semua faham eh?
Faham.
Okay. Itu untuk cari L. Macam mana nak cari C capacitor? Macam nak cari C? Kalau tak ada, saya terus je. I assume you all understand that all of you can solve this problem. So, okay. Next, we have to calculate capacitance per kilometer. This is equation to calculate capacitance per kilometer. Okay. Or you can use other equation. Let's say this one. Okay. So, capacitance per meter equal to 2 pi naught over ln GMD over GMR. C. So, farad per meter. You can use this equation. Or you can use this equation. Okay. So, 0.0556 per ln GMD over GMR. So GMR, GMRC. Okay. If you look at this equation, actually, this R can be replaced by GMRC lah. Okay. Down here. So, what we have to do, we have to calculate GMRC. GMRC is given by R, a cube root of RA, RB, RC. Okay. If for the inductance, we have this inductance. Inductance, we have the SA equal to square root of the S bundle times the A1, A2. For capacitor, almost similar equation, but DS is replaced by R. Now DS become R, RA. We just replace DS to A. Sorry, to R. So now DS become R. So RA equal to same equation. This is use DS, now we use R, R bundle times D A1, A2. Okay. If you look at this, RA equal to R bundle cube square root of R bundle times DA1 A2. What is this R bundle? Okay. This R bundle, same as inductors. If inductors, we have DS bundle equal to square root of DS times D for bundle of 2. Now, for the capacitance, we use R bundle equal to R times D. This DS is replaced by R. You don't have to memorize this one. Usually, we will give the equation, but you have to know what is R, what is DS. Okay. So, R bundle, you have to calculate R bundle by using this equation. Okay. If you look at this, you have to calculate R bundle equal to R. R is radius, D is the displacement. So this is bundle of 2. If you look at this equation, given equation, you have 1, 2, 3 equation for RB. If you look at this, this R bundle, but they have 3 equation. So because our question is bundle of 2, so we use this equation. So bundle of 2 is square root, bundle of 3 is cube root, bundle of 4 is 1.09, the roots of 4, R times this, the power of 3. This is a bundle of three. It's bundle of two. Bundle of two, bundle of three, and bundle of four. It's bundle of four. So same as the previous one. So you have to know the given equation is like this. So ds bundle, ds bundle, also this one also ds bundle. You have to know which one you have to use. Okay. So by calculating the RA, RB, RC, just put in this equation, you can solve the C lah. Okay. So for C, you calculate R bundle, bundle of two. Okay. This R is radius. So how can we get this radius? Radius is come from the diameter. So given in the question, we have 4.4069 cm. So this is diameter. So we just divide this value with 2 to get the radius. Okay. So we get the value of radius 0.02203. And this is this displacement. So we will get this R bundles for bundle of two. Okay. So we put this number in this equation, we can find RA, RB, and RC. Finally, just find the MRC is cube root of RA, RB, RC. We will get this value. Just put in this equation. This general equation for the capacitance. 0.0556 long GMD over GMR. Okay, GMD is same as inductance. GMR, this GMRC. Okay, we will get this value. So just put in this equation. So we will get this value in terms of microfarad per kilometer. Okay, this is microfarad per kilometer. So we can solve this equation. So we get this value. That's how we calculate capacitance per kilometer. Okay. So any there's a bundle of two. Okay. If no question, okay. So the step to solve the equation is you have to know the distance between this cable first. A to B, A1 to B1, A2, this one A2, A2 to B2, A2 to B, and so on. Okay, that's how we start. So, anyone to ask something about this question? This is bundle of two. Conductor with this two composed of two ACSR. That means this bundle lah, bundle of two lah. Okay. If don't have questions, let's move to another example lah. Say this one. Same problem. Now this is a cable. Okay. Let's say we have same distance. This is the distance between the cable. This space A one. B1, C1, A2. Now the arrangement is like this: A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2. This one, 16, 24, 17. 16 meter, 24 meter, 17 meter. This 10 meter, this one 9 meter. The same with the previous problem. So how to solve this equation? Yeah, this problem. Let's say this question number two. What type of bundle is this? So if you look at this, this is bundle. Bundle of what? This transmission line have bundle or not?
No.
No bundle, right? Okay, no bundle. It's only one cable. One cable for phase A, one cable for phase B, and then another one. This is three phase. This circuit, this is another three phase circuit. Don't have bundle. Only have one cable. So How to calculate GMD? GMD, I think is same, right? DAB, DBC, DCA. So you have to calculate DAB lah, BC and CA. So the difference is in the bundle, so GMR. You want to calculate GMR, you have to know DS bundle or not. In this case, DS don't have DS bundle, don't have bundle, so just use DS in the equation. Previously, we use DS bundle, huh, this one. We have to calculate DS bundle. Okay, let's say this one. This is general equation. Why I show you this example? Because general equation to calculate DSA, okay, to calculate DSA, let's say this one. Calculate DSA, the general equation will give you this equation. The square root of DS bundle times DS A1 and A2. Because in our example, in our question 2, we don't have DS bundle. We just replace this equation DS bundle. So this equation with DS don't have bundle, which is this DS equal to this value given GMR 1.7374 centimeter. Okay, this difference between this question 2 and the previous tutorial question, okay, with this question. This question bundle of 2. This question don't have bundle. So when you want to solve this one, just use DS instead of using DS bundle. So don't try to calculate DS bundle, otherwise you cannot calculate because you don't have A1, A2. To calculate DS bundle, so you have to know this displacement. Okay, sorry. This one. You have to know this displacement between this A1 and A2 lah. D. Okay. This displacement. Okay. Some of students, when they got this type of example or question, they try to find DS bundle. So they try to formulate their own equation, something like this. So you know, they try to find DS bundle. They know that DS bundle is equal to square root of DS times D. So they don't know what is the value of D, so they just assume D is equal to diameter, which is this totally wrong lah. This is not diameter. This D is displacement between two cable. Okay, this is D, not diameter. Okay. So in this example, we don't have bundle, so just use DS lah. Okay. So don't use this one. Just use DS equal to 1.7374 centimeter. The rest is the same lah. Okay. Same goes to the R bundle lah. So don't calculate R bundle, just use R. Okay. For this one, for inductors. For capacitor, just use R. Don't use R bundle because in this question, we don't have bundle. Okay. Please remember this one. Okay. So R. R bundle, we didn't use, so we use R. So just use R in this equation. So instead of using this R bundle, okay, we use R. So now, in calculating RA, RA is equal to square root of R bundle. So don't try to find R bundle because depends on the question. in our in this question, we don't have bundle, so just use R. This one, R bundle is replaced by R. Okay, so this RA. So RA square root of R times D. Yeah, sorry. R times D. R times D, D A1, D A2. Times D A1, A2. Okay. That's all the difference between this single cable with this bundle conductor. Okay. So how about bundle of three? This bundle don't have bundle. Let's say this one, bundle of three. So we have 1, 2, 3 cable. So usually they will hang like this. So we have another 1, 2, 3 for phase B. We have another 1, 2, 3 for phase C. Yeah. Okay, this single circuit. We have another three phase circuit over here to make it double circuit. And this is bundle of three. So this is displacement between the bundles. So let's say this D equal to 40 cm. 46 cm. And this is the displacement between the subconductor. Conductor in phase, let's say this phase A1, B1, C1. This one A2, B2, C2. The displacement between this conductor in phase C2. Okay. So this is displacement. So when we have this type of bundle of three, bundle of three. So to calculate GMD and GMR, we have to calculate bundle and DS bundle. So we have to have DS bundle. So bundle of three, this is bundle of two, and this is bundle of three. We use this equation for DS bundle of three. This is cube root of DS times D squared. Okay. This bundle of three. So you have to familiarize this equation by doing a lot of exercises. Okay. Same goes to RA. RA is equal to square root of R bundles. This now bundle of three. If we look at this equation, R bundle, this R bundle of two cables, R bundle of three cables. This cube root of R times D squared. This is bundle of three. So you have to know which one is bundle of two, which one is bundle of three, which one is bundle of four. Okay. In the equation, it will generalize like this. If you did not familiar with the equations, then you might have the problem to use this equation. Okay. This is bundle of three. And we have another one, bundle of four. If bundle of four, this configuration, bundle, let's say this bundle of four. So use bundle of four. With this displacement, okay. So any question? Okay. This is question. What is the 72/7? This is the name of conductor, lah. Okay. We refer to the Hadis Adab book. So this is US standard. This is the name of cable. This is a composite conductor. Okay, composite conductor. And we just show the name of the cables. So don't bother with this name. Okay. This one, we didn't use this value lah. Actually, we can refer to the table to get the resistance and the GMR lah. So I didn't teach how to refer to the cable. So we just give you the exact value of GMR. Otherwise, you have to refer to cable. Okay. So because if you get the wrong GMR, you will get all your calculation wrong lah. Okay. That's why we give you straightforward GMR to use in your calculation. Okay. So any other question? Okay, so I think we just finished how to calculate L and C lah for chapter 3. So any question for chapter 3 before we move to chapter 4?
Sir.
Yeah.
Kalau contoh kan kalau double circuit tu dia kasi one conductor je, dia tak kasi pun GMR. So yang DS tu kita kena guna R eksponen negatif 0.5 ke macam mana?
Tak boleh.
Oh, tak boleh lah.
Tak boleh.
So nanti dia akan mention jugalah GMR tu berapa.
Dia akan mention macam ni eh. Sekejap, soalan dia. Okay ni. Okay. Right. If you look at this soalan, kalau tengok pada soalan ni, so GMR is given. Kenapa dia given? Sebab kabel ni sebenarnya nampak macam satu kabel kan. Sebenarnya dia bukan satu kabel. Ni. Dia ada subconductors ni. So bila ada banyak subconductors, kita tak boleh kira DS macam ni.
Oh.
This only for solid kan? Saya selalu cakap kan? Ini solid conductor. Now we have multiple subconductors. Inside this one, they have multiple. So in the real situation, we didn't use solid conductor. We always use composite conductor. That's why most of the time we refer to the table to get the SR or this value, the S value, GMR value. Okay, so we have to use this GMR as our DS. And this is force composite. Okay. So don't use this equation. Ni untuk solid. Okay.
Ini
untuk solid.
So kalau one conductor untuk R punya guna yang tu lah, yang diameter yang dikasih tu bahagi dengan 2.
Betul. Resistor tu lah. Radius boleh guna yang tu je.
Okay.
So ada soalan lain? Ada yang buat soalan lain nak share? Tak dapat jawapan ke? So dalam buku ni, sekejap.
Soalan chapter 4 se.
Ha?
Soalan chapter 4.
Sekejap chapter 3 dulu. Chapter 3 dah habis eh? Ada soalan lagi tak? Chapter 3.
Sekejap.
Tengok chapter 3 sekejap. Sekejap. Macam mana? Ada soalan chapter 3? Saya buka chapter 3 sebelum pergi chapter 4. So ada yang buat soalan mana dalam buku yang dia guna unit feet tu? Kalau you ada buat soalan dalam buku, dia ada guna, kadang-kadang dia guna feet kan. So feet to inch, ada ramai tanya saya ni, kenapa dia bahagi dengan 12? Ada dia bahagi 12. Ni ada value kan, x bahagi 12. So 12 ni sebenarnya nak tukar just to convert unit from feet to inch lah. So 1 feet sama dengan 12 inch lah. So bila kita nak convert inch to feet, so kita kena bahagi dengan 12 lah. Ada siapa yang buat exercise, dia tahulah apa yang saya cakap ni. So ni bagi 12. So this is just unit conversion lah. Okay, so please make sure you pay attention for the unit lah. Okay. Some book use inch, feet, meter, ada apa lagi unit, miles, miles to km pun lain per kilometer. So this just unit conversion lah. Dalam calculator adalah di belakang, at the back of your calculator, we have unit conversion. You can use that in at the back of your calculator. They have unit conversion code lah. You can use your calculator to convert any units from inch to kilometer and so on lah. Okay. Okay, ada soalan tak? Kalau tak ada, pergi ke chapter 4. So chapter 4. So chapter 4. So chapter 4 saya tengok Dr. Haizat explain detail lah. Ada di dalam kalam kan? So dalam kalam saya tengok dia punya explanation tu okey lah. Dia dah explain semua soalan. Contoh semua. Kalau ada soalan boleh tanya lah. Okey. Soalan apa?
Soalan dalam buku.
Okey.
Muka surat 124.
124. Okey, mana? Mana ada 104?
104.
Example 4.5.
Okey, ha. This log transmission line kan?
Ha, log transmission line.
Okey. So apa masalah dia?
Ya.
Kena bagi tahu masalah dulu.
Yang power.
Ni eh. Ni kot. Ni eh. Soalan ni, lain je. Tak apa. Tak apa. Sebelum kita pergi long, kita pergi tengok yang short dulu lah. So, kena faham. Short transmission line. So, for short transmission line model, so ada masalah tak? So, C, kita abaikan. This short transmission line model. Okay, sorry. This R, this XL. So this short transmission line model. This VS, IS, IR, VR. So for short transmission line model, okay, before that, so in chapter 4, all of our analysis in per phase basis, per phase analysis. So our analysis is per phase. So that's mean for three phase system, three phase we have this three phase, right? Generator, this three phase generator, three phase transformer, and so on. So we represent this three phase by using single phase diagram lah. Single phase network. This single line diagram. So this three phase is converted to single line diagram like this. And then we convert to the impedance diagram for the three phase by using single phase line. Macam ni lah. Okay. This is single phase representation. So because we use per phase basis, all our value must be in phase value. So let's say macam ni eh, sorry. So we have contoh soalan mana soalan. Soalan satu lah dulu. Okay, 4.1. So ni contoh soalan satu. Three phase transmission line 40 kilometer long. Okay, so the modeling is based on the length of the transmission line. Let's say for example 4.1, the line length is 40 kilometer. 40 kilometers is considered the short transmission line because this is below than 80 kilometers transmission line. It's considered a short transmission line. Okay, so this is the rated voltage. This is the frequency. Resistance per phase is given. And inductance per phase per kilometer also given. Okay, so with this value, we have to calculate Z lah. So So we have to represent three-phase network by using single phase like this. This is short transmission line model. We just neglect the value of C lah without any errors lah. Okay. Because C is too small. So this is R. B is J X L. So actually it's Z. Capital Z. Z is equal to small Z times L. This Z is resistance per kilometer. L is the length of the lines. So we have Z small Z, Z equal to R plus J X L per kilometer. So R in our case, this one. So R is 0.15. L, you have to calculate the L. So how to calculate L? 2 by F, L at this, to find SL, sorry. So this SL, R is 0.15 plus J 2 pi F. F is 60. L value is equal to 1.3263 millihenry. So calculate this one to get this small Z lah. So just put this Z in this equation to find the totals, this one Z total of transmission line impedance. This impedance. Z impedance. So in this book, when we calculate Z, we get this value lah. This Z per kilometer, this SL per kilometer times 40, because the length of the line is 40, so we get total Z. Okay. So, and then we have to know what is VS, IS, some VR, IR. So in the question, they ask to, the question asks to find the voltage and power at sending ends, voltage regulation and efficiency when the load, when the line is supplying this load size, this three-phase load. Okay. So we have this transmission line. Load is connected at this point. So we want to find VS, IS, PS, SS. SS. This SS. How to calculate this one? VS. So we know for the short transmission line, VS equal to A VR plus B IR. Okay. This all equation you have to know lah. Okay. This one also C VR plus D IR. So for the short transmission line, actually, if you look at this, we will get this one. Good, will give us IS equal to IR, and then this VS A VR plus B IR. A is one, so we will get VR plus Z IR. Okay. So to calculate VS, you have to know what is VR, what is total Z, what is the IR. Okay. So based on the given data, given the question, so how to calculate IR? Okay. So how to calculate IR? To start, we want to calculate VS, IS, SS. Okay, we want to calculate this one. So how to calculate? So before we calculate this one, we have to know VR and IR. How to calculate VR? VR, because our modeling is in single phase. Okay. This VR, VR as the voltage at the receiving end. Receiving end is the at the load center lah. So VR, based on the question, if you look at this, our load is this value, three-phase load. This is a voltage. This three-phase voltage. Okay, three-phase voltage, that means V line to line. So 220 kV is V line to line. Because our modeling must be in per phase basis. So VR is VR phase. So VR phase equal to VR line to line over square root 3. That's why we divide by square root 3. 220 kV divided by square root 3, you will get the answer lah. That's why VR is 127 degree and 127 kV. Angle zero, because usually we take VR as our references. Okay, when we want to plot the phasor diagram, this is our VR. This VR. This VR. And then for this type of circuit, usually we have lagging power factor. Power factor lagging, that means current lag voltage by several degree. This current IR, lag voltage by this lagging degree lah. Okay. And this is how we plot the phasor diagram. Okay, later on, we will see how to plot this phasor diagram. So we have VR. How to calculate IR? Okay. Now we want to calculate IR. So IR equal to what? So we know that SR three phase equal to square root 3 VR line to line times IR conjugate. Okay. This is equation for three phase power, apparent power. This S is apparent power. Okay. Okay. Wait. So are you listening me? Are you still listening?
Yes.
Anyway.
Sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Because last class I talking to myself because the line is disconnected. I hope today is not disconnected. So, okay. So how to calculate this one? This is apparent power. S equal to square root VR, or you can use this S3 phase, SR, S3 phase, S3 phase. Equal to 3 VR, this one VR phase, times IR phase. Okay. You can use either this one or this one. Actually, this is the same equation. It will give the same answer. So IR, actually, if I take this first equation, the second equation, I take this first equation, I can get IR equal to SR divided by square root 3 VR line to line. And then we have this conjugate. Okay, just put conjugate over here. Okay. So they have a conjugate. That's why when we calculate IR, usually we will get the angle opposite with the SR. So let's say for this one. So from this SR, 381. So SR is given by this value. 381. Wait. This is, so this load is working at 0.8 power factor lagging. 0.8, that's mean you will get the degree lah. How many degree, that's the current lag the voltage. So up cost 0.8, you will get 36 point something lah. Okay. You will get this value for the angle, 36.87 for the angle. That's mean this SR have this angle. Okay. So to calculate the current, you just put this value with the conjugate to get the current. Okay. So now you can calculate the current. Usually for the lagging power factor, the current will always have minus angle. So let's say this one. Then when you calculate this one, you will get current I 1000 angle minus 36.7 degree. Okay. For lagging power factor, the angle current always minus lah. Okay. And the angle for the power is always positive. I mean SR. So SR, you have value and then the angle is 36.87. Always opposite with the current, okay? Because of the conjugates. So now you got the IR and VR. VR, you have 120 degree, angle zero. This is current value, IR. So, kilo ampere, it's on 1000 ampere. Okay. So from this value, now you can calculate VS VR plus ZIR. And then IS equal to IR. So you can calculate VS and IS. Then by using these two equation and these two values, you can calculate S equal to. So if you use this equation, square root 3 VS line to line times IS conjugate. So when you use this equation to calculate VS, you will get VS per phase. This one VS phase. So usually final answer must be convert back to the VS line to line. VS line to line. So usually we will convert back to line to line so that we can compare V sending with the V receiving. Okay. Because in the question, they will give us in terms of V sending. V line to line. So V line to line at the receiving end. So we have to calculate V line to line at the sending end. This receiving end, we have to calculate V line to line at the sending end. So that's why in this book they will convert VS into the V line to line. Okay. That's why we convert back to line to line. Then by using these parameters I and VS, you can calculate SS lah. In this book they use this equation. Okay. If you can see this one, 3 times VS times IS. Conjugate. They use 3 because they use VS phase. They use VS as 144, not VS line to line. This is VS line to line. VS line to line is 250. Because they use VS phase, they use 3. 3 times VS times IS conjugate. Okay. You can use this equation or you can use square root 3 times VS line to line. Okay. It will give the same answer. Okay. So next. They ask us to calculate the voltage regulation and efficiency. So voltage regulations, so VR. This value, actually the representation of voltage difference between, okay, let's say this is our transmission line. We are supplying the loads, this load. This VR represent when this line did not supply to load. That means V, no load. When there's no loads, to when there is a full load. VR no load, VR full load. Sorry, full load. So what is the difference between VR no load when no load connected at this bus bar and when there is full load connected to this bus bar? What happened to the voltage? So voltage regulations means the difference in voltage in percentage showing that the voltage difference when there is no load connected to the when there is bus bar, when this bus bar is connected to the full load lah. So the equation is VR percentage of voltage regulation equal to VR from no load. Usually when no loads, the voltage here is higher lah because there's no load, right? No load, the voltage is higher to the voltage VR full load. Full load means this transmission line supplying the maximum load size. For our case, the maximum load is this load lah, 381 megawatts mega VA. This is a full load. Okay. So when the line is supplying at this full load, what happened to the voltage? That's why we want to calculate the voltage regulations. The less voltage regulation is the better system lah. Okay. So that means this voltage is more stable. Okay. So percentage of VR is given by VR no loads minus VR full load over VR full load. Okay. So to calculate VR no load, in our case, VR no load is equal to what? This VR full load is given. VR full load is given. So VR full load is given here. When the transmission line supplying this much of load, the voltage at the load center is 220 kV. This is voltage level at the full load condition. Okay. So VR full load is equal to 220 kV. So how to calculate VR no loads? We know that VS equal to AVR plus VIR. Okay, this is our first equation. For short transmission lines, medium or long, this is a basic equation, which is this ABCD parameters is coming from the two ports network that we use in our transmission line. Okay. I hope you understand the two port representation. So we have this equation. Okay, nah. Okay, so we have this VS, this IS equal to AVR plus BIR CVR DIR. Okay, I hope you understand this one. We want to what ABCD. We want to relate between the input and output of the system. So for the input, we have VS and IS. So that for the output, we have VR and IR. Okay. So general equation for the representation of this two-port network is given by this equation. So we can relate between VS and VR in terms of A, B, C, D parameters. Okay. This is general. For short transmission line, this A actually equal to 1. This A equal to 1, B equal to Z, C equal to 0, D equal to 1. This is parameter, ABCD parameter for short transmission line. So you may see Dr. Haizat video lah to know about this one. So now, because we have this general equation. So we have this one, Vs equal to AVR plus BIR. At no load, so at no load, that's mean there is no current flow. At no load, that's mean there is no current flow to the load. So this, let's say this is our transmission line model. This load, okay. When there is no load connected, that's mean IR is equal to zero, okay. At no load, IR is equal to zero. So this equation, Vs will become Vs equal to AVR no load, okay. So now we have Vs equal to AVR no load. Let's say this is equation X, okay. So from X, VR no load actually equal to Vs over magnitudes of A. Okay, and this is based general equation to calculate VR no load. Okay, but for short transmission line, we know that A is equal to 1. So that's why in many references, they will use VR no load for short transmission line is equal to Vs. Okay. Okay, because A is equal to 1. This only true for short transmission line. So for the medium and long, you have to calculate by using this equation. Use this equation for VR no load. Okay, so because of this, percentage of VR no load. So VR no load is equal to Vs. So they already calculate Vs, this Vs. So you just take this as Vs 250 minus 220. This is VR no load, this is VR full load. Okay, over VR full load times 100, you will get voltage regulation. Okay. So this is how we calculate the voltage regulation. Okay. And then the other one is, so this one you have to put the VR no load minus VR full load. VR full load times 100 lah. So you will get 13% whatsoever lah. So this is how we calculate VR. So second one is we want to calculate the efficiency of the transmission line. Efficiency is equal to PR over PS times 100%. This is the measurement of the power received at the sending end, power received by the receiving end as compared to power that's being sent from the sending end. This power supply, this power received. So actually there is a power loss in the transmission lines. So we want to calculate the efficiency of this transmission line because of power loss. Okay. So PS, PR. So you have to calculate PR. So how to calculate PR? PR is taken from SS. SS equal to square root 3. Actually this one is given, right? So VR IR. Okay. Actually this is given. This one. PR is taken from SR. Okay, this one is given. So in this case, power is given, sending as a receiving power is given. So 381 mega VA. So just put 381 MVA. So there's angle, right? 36.87, if I'm not mistaken. So this the SR. So you just change this phasor into the rectangular lah. So SR equal to PR plus JUR. Okay. Just change this into this form, rectangular form. So you will get PR. This PR will be used in this equation. Okay. And this VR. If you look at this solution in this book, so actually this book is available in the column. So based on this, okay, this one. So they already calculate this one S. Sorry, this one SS. And so on, SR. So this SR equal to PR plus JQR. This is PR, 304.8. Okay. This SR. So just take this value, put the into the efficiency equation. So the second one is you have to calculate SS. SS equal to this equation. Okay. Just now. So you change this form into the rectangular like this. This is PS. So you take this value, put in this equation. So PR 304 is taken from SR, this SR. Okay, this SR. SR equal to PR plus JQR. This is apparent power. This is real power. This one is reactive power. Okay, this is real power. Take this value, put in this equation. This one also is taken from PS, taken from this value. This is apparent power, SS. This is real power at the sending end. This is reactive power at the sending end. Just take this value, put in this equation times 100. Then you will get the efficiency of the transmission line. Okay. That's for the short transmission line model. Okay, now we go to the medium. So before that, any question? Short medium also same, except okay. Except now we have okay. So before we go to the medium, so are you still with me? You want to proceed or you want to stop here?
So yang untuk test nanti masuk yang mana?
Masuk sampai habis. Chapter 3 and chapter 4. Okay, chapter 4 until long transmission line. Okay, so that's for short transmission line. Okay, short. So saya habis short kat situ. We move to the medium. So medium line. So medium. So medium line. So between 80 km to 240 lah. Okay. Ini medium lah. Medium 8. Bigger than 80 TL. Less than 240 kilometers. This is medium transmission line. So medium, we have two type of modeling. We can model by using this pi model. Okay, this pi model. Or T model like this. Okay, and this T model. Okay, so in our class we just focus on this pi model. Actually, we can do the same, and we can do both, but it will give the same same answer. So either one, you can use this pi model or can use a T model. So in this class we focus on pi model. So pi model. So for the medium transmission line, we have to consider the value of C, but now we have to divide this C into two values. One is lump at the sending end, another one is lump at the receiving end. So we have this y over 2 over here. We have another y over 2. This is z. Because of this, we can find A, B, C, D parameter for medium tension line with the pi model. A, B, C, sorry, C, D parameter. So A equal to what, B equal to what, C, and so on. Okay. A is equal to, if I'm not mistaken, so 1 plus ZY equal to 2. This one Z. So D equal to A. So on Y. 1 plus Z 1 per 4. And this is the parameter. So let's see in this module. 4 pi. This pi. And this is parameter 4 pi. So 1 plus ZY over 2 ZY y times 1 plus ZY over 4. Okay. So now, this is only the difference between short and medium transmission line. So, okay. So if we have the same questions, but now, okay, let's say this is a question. Now, instead of 40 kilometers, okay, let's say this is the same question. Instead of the length of the transmission line is 40 kilometers long, now it's become 100 kilometer long. Let's say this is 100 kilometer long, then it can be considered as a medium transmission line. So usually for the medium transmission line, it will provide us the admittance data or capacitance value. So in this case, it doesn't have the capacitance value. Usually it will give us a capacitance value to represent the effect of the capacitance for a medium transmission line. Okay. So the rest is same. We have to calculate VR, then we have to calculate IR. By knowing VR and IR, we can calculate SS, efficiency, and so on. So what is the difference? Only this one.
Bahaya ni sangat. Okay, boleh dah. So we beli ni.
So this is for pi model. So any question for pi model? So you want to see the calculation?
Okay, really, yeah.
Medium pi.
Amiruddin, ada soalan tak?
Oh, Amiruddin.
No, sir. No.
Awak tengah cakap ke belakang.
Okay.
Ada soalan.
Nak tanya kalau yang Patrice tu apa dia? Patrice lah apa lah. Dia ada kan nama-nama itu.
Itu just nama konduktor lah. Nama konduktor. US dia guna nama burung. So, tak payah ambil kiraan tu. Tak penting pun.
Okay.
Tak penting.
So, macam mana nak tentukan yang soalan tu adalah short line model?
Kita tengok. You tengok sini. Short line model when the transmission line, the length of the line is less than 80 kilometers, right? Short. 80 kilometers and below is short line model. If 130 is considered, apa dia ni? Medium kan? Length of the lines. Baca lah dulu. Awal tak baca lah. Baca. Okay, kita ada short. The medium. Long line model. This one less than 80 kilometer. Consider short. This is between 80 to 240 ya. Higher than 240, consider long. Ni lah, ni lah cara kita nak tahu the short, medium atau long. The length of the transmission line. Okay. Yang ni kita C kita abaikan. Ni ni ada C. Ha, ni adalah C. Kalau macam ni C kita lamkan at the sending end dan juga receiving end. Kalau yang ni kita tak boleh lam. Ni dia ada banyak RC dia. So dia ada banyak transmission line. So dia ada, dia tak boleh lam. So dia akan tambah yang ni, tambah yang ni, tambah lagi banyak-banyak sampai dia jadi long. That's why dia dia akan ada, dia akan guna hyperbolic punya calculation lah. So dia akan guna cos, sin, hyperbolic and so on lah. Okay. So ni adalah cara kita nak tentukan short, medium or long transmission line. So for medium saya rasa tak ada masalah lah. So yang you kena cari adalah Z dengan Y. Apa itu Z, apa itu Y? Okay, so Z equal to small Z ni per kilometer times L. Y apa sama lah? Y times L lah. Okay. So kita tengok. Mana medium? Ini medium. So kalau Z dah ada tadi, ni untuk Y. Saya beritahu dari itu. Admittance is equal to G. G is conductance. J omega C lah. So G ni biasa kita akan assume sebagai kosong lah. This is a, where the current leakage of the transmission line lah. Current leakage too small, we consider as kosong lah. Okay. So tinggal lagi J omega C. This is admittance. So total admittance sama dengan J omega C times L. L is the length of the lines. So kita akan dapat Z dengan juga, kita akan dapat ni, nilai Z sama dengan short. Dan untuk medium kita cuma ada tambah Y lah. Okay. So ada Z ada Y. So kita boleh solve lah kita punya transmission line model ni. Tadi dah cari A, B, C, D parameter. A, B, C, D. Cuma A dia lain lah. A tu apa? Ha, A tu sama dengan 1 tambah Z, Y per 2. Tadilah ni sama dengan Z. Ni sama dengan A. Ni sama dengan Y. 1 tambah Z, Y per 4. So yang ni boleh refer lah dalam. Biasa kita akan bagi yang ni equation ni. Okay. So ini saja beza untuk medium. Okay. So you have to calculate Z and then calculate Y and then the rest VS, IS sama saja dengan yang tadi. Cuma VS dia sama dengan A VR plus B IR. So this A, A yang you calculate daripada sini lah. Kita calculate A, masuk dalam equation ni. Ni A dia. B pun sama. Calculate B, ni B masuk dalam equation sini. Itu saja beza dia. Sini ada C VR plus DIR. Calculate A, B, C, D ni dan masukkan equation ni. The rest is the same lah for medium line. Okay. So terus pergi kepada long lah. Ha, ini long. So, ada soalan nak medium line ni? Soalan? Yeah, okay. So saya nak sentuh yang ni sikit. So biasanya kita kira VS dan IS kan. So kita ada gini. Ini matrik tadilah. Kalau kita write in matrik VS equal to VS IS equal to A B C D VR to IR. Ini kalau kita tulis dalam bentuk matrik sah. Okay. So macam mana pula kalau diberi VS dan juga IS, macam mana nak cari VR, IR? Kalau kita nak cari VR, IR, macam mana nak cari? Kalau diberi VS, IS, so kita kena buat macam ni. VR, IS sama 1 per AD tolak BC. So this D minus B minus B minus minus C B minus C A. Ni cara kita nak kira VRIR lah. Jika VSIS kita tahu. Okay. Ni adalah VS ni IS. Okay. That's why dalam kita punya modul ni dia ada bagi satu contoh. Dia bagi, saya tak ingat ada soalan mana. Dia bagi VSIS, dia suruh kira VRIR. Wah, bukan soalan ni, soalan lain kot. Soalan ni 4.4. So dia bagi VSIS, dia kata descending end voltage dia bagi, sending end current dia bagi. Okay, dia dah bagi sending end current dan sending end voltage. Macam mana nak kira receiving end current and receiving end voltage dan lain-lain parameter lah. So cara dia, kita guna equation ni. Yeah, kita guna equation ni. Untuk kes yang ni, AB minus BC sama dengan 1. Okay, so inilah dia punya equation dia. So, kalau kita tengok, so nak kira VR ni, tak kali ni, D V S minus B I S dan 1 I R equal to ni ya. Boleh tak macam ni? Minus C V S plus A I S. Ini dua. Ha, ni equation yang kita guna untuk calculate VS, sorry, VR dan juga IR. When VS and IS is given. Okay. So by knowing this VR and IR, so kita boleh calculate lah S, R dan sebagainya. So kita boleh calculate voltage regulation dan juga efficiency. Okay. So ini ada dalam buku ni. Okay. So itu untuk medium dan boleh guna juga untuk short dan boleh juga guna untuk long lah. Okay. Ini dalam buku ada nominal P lah. Sebenarnya kita boleh apa dia, derive equation ni. Saya dalam kelas biasa saya, yang pi lah saya biasa derive, yang p ni yang biasa saya suruh student derive. Saya boleh derive lah yang equation ni, macam mana dapat nilai ni lah. Mungkin Dr. Haizat dah derive kot dalam kelas, macam mana awak dapat ha, ni, daripada lita ni boleh derive mana tak? Macam mana dapat ABCD parameters ni. Okay, ni lah ABCD parameters, mana kena dapat nilai ni. Okay, so itu yang untuk medium. So tadi kawan awak nak tanya untuk long, so kita pergi kat long. Sebelum long tu saya buka untuk soalan lah. Ada soalan yang untuk pi? Ada soalan tak? Tak ada soalan? Tak ada. So you all masih ada lagi kan?
Ada.
So kita pergi pada long. So long.
Ada sir.
Okay. So mana long? Sekejap. Long dari segi teori ni awak tengok yang Dr. Haizat ajar lah. Saya rasa dia dah ajar kok. Dah okay dah. Tengok je dia punya mana? Dia punya video tu. Long. Ini long. Okay, cuma long ni dia ada trick dekat calculator tu. So biasanya okay. Ni sama je. Kira R, XL, Y ni semua sama kan? Saya rasa sama je, tak ada masalah ni. You kira Z impedance R plus BXL. So you kena kalilah awal-awal. R, this R is R per kilometer, B just sekali lah berapa transmission line long tu. Sorry, medium. Okay. Okay ni. Lebih tinggi daripada 250 km, consider long. Depends pada buku lah. Ada buku 240, ada buku ni dia guna 250. So guna yang ni lah. 250. More than 250 km is considered as long transmission line. So for long transmission line, capacitance cannot be ignored. And then capacitance is considered distributed instead of lumps at the sending and at the receiving end as the medium. Now we consider C as a distributed along the transmission lines. Because of the distributed effect, kita kena derive. Maksudnya dia ada derivation lah ni. Derivation, macam mana kita nak kira ABCD parameters ni. So saya tak boleh detail lah kat sini. So you tengok yang ni. Finally, kita akan dapat macam ni. Mana dia? Ini. So A parameter, so ABCD parameter for long transmission line, A is cos gamma L. Gamma. Ni mana dia? Ha, ni. So daripada Y tadi, yang ni adalah dia derive. So dia ada dua terms lah kat sini. So satu ni karakteristik impedance ZC. So you kena calculate ZC dan juga propagation constant ni. Ni yang panggil gamma. ZC is karakteristik impedance is given by this equation. Okay. You kena calculate yang ni. Z per Y. And then gamma which is called propagation constant, you kena calculate lah. So you nak calculate yang ni pun saya rasa you dah tak boleh. Betul tak? Ada siapa-siapa yang try buat long transmission line? Nak klik Z, nak calculate ZC dan juga gamma. Saya rasa you ada problem nak calculate. Boleh tak calculate? You try.
Boleh ke?
Kalau you try, you tahulah. So sekarang you nak calculate, you nak dapatkan okay, ZC ya. Punca kuasa 2 Z over Y. Okay, YZ gamma sama dengan square root YZ. So ini adalah dia panggil complex number kan. Z ni ada complex number. So you nak katakan ni A plus JB bahagi C plus JD. So ini complex number. So calculator tak boleh selesaikan ni complex number ni. Contoh ni equation ni. So macam mana nak selesaikan? Katakan equation you ada square root mana? A angle theta divide by B angle ni delta ni. So macam mana nak selesaikan guna calculator? So calculator tak boleh selesai. Siapa-siapa yang dah try mungkin dia dah tahulah cara nak selesaikan dia. Ataupun mungkin tak boleh selesai lah. So dia ada satu teorem. Teorem apa lah? Saya pun tak ingat lah nama teorem dia. So macam ni. Nak selesaikan yang ni, sebenarnya macam ni. Ni A bahagi B angle macam mana ni? Theta tolak delta bahagi 2. Ha, inilah cara dia. Dia ada nama. Tak silap saya di Moivre apa tah. Macam ginilah nama dia lebih kurang. Ada satu teorem untuk kita dapatkan square root of complex number. So from this value, we can simplify by using this equation. So A over B square root of A over B angle instead of this angle bahagi yang ni. Okay, kita tolak angle ni, tolak angle ni bahagi 2. Okay, itu cara kita nak selesaikan dia lah. So kalau untuk gamma punca kuasa ni untuk ZC eh. So awak try dulu buat, nanti awak tahulah macam mana nak selesaikan ni. Untuk ZC. So untuk Y dan untuk gamma punca kuasa 2 yang ni kali yang ni. Let's say A angle theta kali B angle delta ni. So dia akan jadi macam ni. Punca kuasa 2 A times B angle delta plus delta ni theta ni plus delta bahagi 2. Ha, inilah cara kita nak selesaikan. Cari ZC dan juga gamma ni. Ni karakteristik impedance, ni propagation constant. Okay. This dua parameter ni. Okay. Itu satu trick dia. Nak selesaikan ZC dan gamma. Siapa yang tak tengok video ni ataupun tak belajar, memang tak boleh solve lah. Long transmission line ni. Okay, satu lagi. Apa lagi ya? Okay, ni. Okay, ni dia ada statement ni. So, biasanya macam ni. Gamma ni sama dengan alpha plus j beta. Okay. So, bila kita nak kira alpha dan beta, bila kita nak guna alpha dan beta ni? So, okay, macam ni. Alpha dan beta ni kita akan guna bila kita nak kira ni. Contoh kita ada sinh gamma x sama dengan sinh alpha yang ni kan. Okay. So yang ni kita boleh kembangkan dia. Cos alpha x plus j beta x. Actually kita boleh kembangkan equation ni jadi yang ni lah. Cos alpha x cos beta x. So this alpha and beta must be in radian mode lah. Okay. So value yang ni sebenarnya adalah dalam radian. Contoh eh. So macam ni. Macam mana? So kita ada gamma sama dengan alpha plus j beta. Okay. So kita nak cari A, B, C, D parameter. So apa dia A, apa dia B, apa dia C, apa dia D. Tengok untuk long transmission line, A adalah mana E dia? Ha ni. Cos gamma L. E dia. Cos gamma L. So, kita nak selesaikan cos gamma L ni. Calculator tak boleh selesaikan ni. So cos sebab L ni adalah ni alpha plus j beta. So ini adalah dalam radian lah. So kita kena guna mode radian untuk calculate cos gamma L. Cos gamma L ni kita kena kembangkan dia. Macam mana selesaikan ni? Seperti mana yang ditulis dalam buku ni. Ni ya. Cos gamma L ni sama dengan yang ni lah. Cos alpha plus J beta. So yang ni pun calculator tak boleh selesai kan. So yang ni saya padam dulu. So sama dengan ni. Cos alpha cos beta dengan cos alpha X. Sorry, ni cos. Cos. Ni cos. COS cos. Cos alpha X cos beta X plus J sin alpha X. Sorry. Sin alpha X sin beta X. Ha, inilah cara kita nak selesaikan ni parameter A ni. Kena try satu soalan dulu. Okay, kita cuba buat satu soalan untuk dapatkan A. B pun sama. B, kalau B, tengok B eh. Kalau B yang saya since, since gamma tu silap saja. Okay, ZC since gamma. So, tadi ZC kita dah kira untuk B. Since hyperbolic, gamma L. So, ni kita kena kembangkan dia juga. Since gamma L. So, macam mana cara kembangkan dia? Inilah, kena ikutlah dalam equation ni. Okay. Kalau kita selalu buat, kita boleh ingat lah. Saya lama dah tak buat. Saya tak ingat. Biasa saya tengok je dekat buku ni. Tengok dekat dia punya apa, appendix lah. Appendix dia akan bagi equation ni. How to calculate sinh gamma x. Okay. Sinh hyperbolic alpha x cos bx j cos sinh cos. Okay. So buat cara yang ni untuk dapatkan sinh hyperbolic ni. Tapi kita kena guna dalam radian mode. Calculator kita mas kena tukar dalam radian mode lah. So bila kita calculate mesti tukar pada radian, mode radian calculator kita. Supaya baru dapat kira ni. Kalau tak nanti kita salah. Okay. So kita tengok contoh. Contohlah. Ini soalan 1. 4.7. So long transmission line deliver load of this load at power factor 0.8 lagging resistance of the transmission lines. This is total resistance. Resistance of the lines, that means this is total resistance. Reactance, this is total reactance. And admittance, this is Z and this is SL. This is admittance Y due to charging capacitance. This is Y. Dia dah bagi total lah, tak perlu lagi kali. Okay. So, kalau refer pada soalan ni, okay, kita ada long transmission line. So step 1 dia kita kena kira Z sama dengan berapa, Y sama dengan berapa. Okay, tu kes yang ni Z. Z dia dah bagi R 25.3. Ni 25.3. JSL, JSL, SL and reactants. This already SL lah. SL, total SL is 66.5 ohm. 66.5 ohm. This total, Z total lah, capital Z. Okay, so Y, this is total Y, 0.442. More, okay, 0.442 more, this is Y. So kita dah ada nilai Z, kita dah ada nilai Y. So, okay. Bila dah dapat Z dengan Y, tak perlu lagi kali. Tak perlu lagi cari Z equal to small Z times L. So, tak perlu. Ini tak payah. Y pun tak payah cari dah. Tak payah cari, sebab dia dah bagi total. This is total. Total Z and total Y lah. So, tak perlu lagi cari yang ni. Okay. So, kita dah ada nilai ni. So, tugas kita, kita nak cari ZC equal to square root of Z over Y ataupun dan juga gamma lah, square root Y Z, Y Y times Z. Okay, so cari nilai tu. So, saya berhenti kat sini dulu. Saya bagi awak peluang cari Y dengan Z. Okay. Okay, cuba cari ni nilai ZC, sorry. Y dengan Z dah ada, cari ZC dan juga gamma ni. So, ZC Kuasa 2 nilai ni. Nilai ni saya kita kena tukar kepada phase lah. Baik. Lama. So you cuba, kalau you tak cuba you tak tahu. Lama. Satu banding. J ya. So itu nilai yang saya dapat. Ada siapa-siapa yang kira tak? Ni, sesi ni. Ada yang kira tak? Saya dapat nilai ni. So ZC ni. So ZC ya. So ZC ni tak ada unit. Sorry, ZC is ohm lah. Y over Z. Okay, ZC is ohm. Y yang tak ada unit. So, ni ohm lah unit dia. Ni ohms. Okay, Z eh. Impedance, unit dia ohms. Propagation constant, tak ada unit. Okay, so yang ni, kena calculate lah. Ni yang saya dapat nilai dia. So, ZC, Y times Z. So, Y, ni Y. 0.442 times ini gamma sama dengan 0.1773. Itu 9.59. Ini ada angle ni. Angle dia 0.59. So ini ZC nilai dia, ini adalah propagation constant lah. So dia tak ada unit. So tak, daripada dua nilai ni kita kena kira A. Okey. Macam mana kira A? Cos alpha plus J beta sama dengan cos alpha cos beta is alpha alpha beta plus J sin hyperbolic alpha sin beta. Okay, jadi alpha beta ni nilai ni. This nilai alpha, this nilai beta lah. Okay. So alpha dalam kes yang kita tadi, alpha sama dengan beta sama dengan apa? Daripada gamma. So ni. Ini nilai kita tadi. Dapat kosong misal kosong. Salah ni. Okay, ni alpha kan, alpha beta. So kita dapat gamma tadi. So yang ni sama dengan 0.1773 angle 79.59. Alamak. So just convert this value into the rectangular punya form. So kita akan dapat point 1773 angle 79.59 rectangular 0.032. Plus J 0.1744. Okay. Ini nilai dia. Ini adalah nilai alpha, ini adalah nilai beta. So sini adalah 0.032. Ini 0.1744. Cuba cek ni ya. Ada yang kira tak? Ada yang dapat sama tak? Okay, ada soalan tak? Ke dah tak ada lah.
Sir, yang dekat ZC tu, kira ha. ZC tu kan, sudut dia tu ha. 69.17 tolak dengan 90 bagi 2 kan?
Ha. Yang mana? Yang mana?
Ya, ZC, kira ZC tu kan? Ha. 69.17 tolak 90 bagi 2 kan?
Ha, betul. Ini bagi 2. Sorry. So, dapat berapa nilai ZC tu? Ini angle 10.41 lah kan?
Ha, negatif 10.415.
Okay, so yang ni betul tak? Betul kan nilai ni?
Ah, tu betul, tu betul.
Ni yang gamma ni betul tak?
Ah, gamma tu sekejap saya nak kira.
Kira-kira. Nanti siapa yang tak tengok video ni ataupun dia tak belajar cara kira ni memang dia tak boleh jawab lah. Ada satu soalan ni sama ada test ataupun final lah untuk long transmission line. Kalau dah keluar test tak keluar final. Kalau dah keluar final tak keluar test. Ha, yang ni pun sama. Yang ni pun ada bahagi dua. Okay, so yang ni saya dah bagi dua, betul ni 79.59. So saya dapat nilai 0.032, okay, betul. B 0.1744. So saya dapat nilai ni betul ni. Okay. So sekarang kita nak kira A. So A cos 0.032 cos beta sama dengan ni 0.1744 tambah J sins 0.032 ni kali sin sin 0.1744. So cuba kira ni. So dalam unit radian so calculator kena tukar kepada dalam unit radian lah. So kita ada degree radian, gradient tu ambil yang nombor 2 radian. Okey. Cos. Hyperbolic cos. Hyperbolik cos 0.32 kali cos 0.9853 J hyperbolik sin 0.032 kali sin 0.1744. Nilai ni. Kosong poin. Kosong, kosong, satu. Kosong, kosong. Lima. Enam. Dua, tiga. Okay. Enam. Ini nilai A. Kalau tengok pada jawapan tadi. Okay. Nilai 0.98 angle yang ni. Tengok jawapan kita. 0.98 betul dah. Yang ni dalam radian. Kalau kita nak tukar pada angle.
Sir.
Ya.
Yeah. Ya, cos tu nak kira macam mana dalam calculator?
Mana?
Cos.
Cos tekan hyperboliknya. Dia ada HYP kan? Hyperbolik. Dekat calculator awak ada HYP, cari HYP. Hyperbolic cos.
Hyperbolic cos.
Ah, dia akan tulis macam ni. HYP. Ha, button ni. Tekan button ni. Plus button cos lah.
Oh, terima kasih dah.
Okay, dapat ni. Tapi dalam mode radian eh.
Okay.
Ya, yang ni ramai student salah. So kalau convert pada phasor diagram, awak akan dapat macam ni. Yeah. Tak muat pula tulis. Okay ni, nampak dia. 0.9853 angle 0.0056 rad ni, radian ni, dalam unit radian. Kalau kita nak convert pada degree, so you akan dapat 0.9853. Tukar balik dalam mode degree. Kalkulator kita just tukar dalam mode degree, kita akan dapat dalam degree sini 0.3333256. Saya ambil 33 lah. Sorry, 0.33 3256 sebenarnya. So saya ambil 33. Ini adalah A. Kalau kita compare dengan jawapan yang dibagi dalam buku ni, okay, 0.986 betul, sama dengan kita, saya kira. Ataupun lari sikit sebab dia dah bundar kan, ataupun dia guna MATLAB kan, tak pasti. Ni dapat 0.32. So dapatlah nilai ni. Okay, so itu untuk A. Untuk B pun sama, B, C pun sama. So bila dah dapat A, B, C, D, so the rest is the same lah. So kita kena calculate B pula. Sin hyperbolik gamma, gamma L lah. Ni gamma L kan. So untuk kes kita, alpha plus J beta. Yang ni eh. So kita tengok balik macam mana dia nak expandkan equation ni. Ni sin hyperbolik cos hyperbolik sin. So sin hyperbolik alpha cos beta plus j cos hyperbolik alpha sin beta. Okay, sin cos sin. Okay, itu cara kita nak cari A, B, C, D lah. So C pun sama, C, carilah nilai C dan D. So C ni apa, D tu apa. Kita tengok pada ni, C adalah satu per Z C sin. Sorry, B ada ZC kat depannya. So B, ZC, ZC sin hyperbolik. So carilah nilai ni. Nanti aku cari nilai ni kali dengan ZC lah. So biasanya kalau untuk soalan ni, okay. So step yang biasalah saya buat, saya akan cari macam ni. Step 1, cari Z, small Z times L, Y sama dengan Y times L. Kalau dapat dua ni, kita kena cari ZC, karakteristik impedance ni. ZC sama dengan square root of Z over Y. Lepas tu kita cari Y. Okay, Y Y, sorry, bukan Y, Y pula. Ini gamma, sorry. Cari gamma, square root of Y Z lah. Okay, cari semua ni. Ni dah dapat semua empat parameter ni. Lepas tu step 2, saya akan cari ni, cos L dan juga cos hyperbolik untuk bukan L, sorry, gamma L ni. Ni gamma L, ni alpha L lah. Hai. Ni gamma L. Nah, cari dua ni dulu. cos hyperbolic untuk gamma, sin hyperbolic untuk gamma lah. Ni yang kita buat elaboration tadi. Cos sama cos alpha cos beta tambah j sin hyperbolic alpha sin beta lah. Ni sin hyperbolic cari ni. Cos sin ni sin. Sin hyperbolic alpha cos beta plus j cos hyperbolic alpha sin beta. Nah, cari semua parameter ni dulu. Dan lepas tu baru masuk cari A, B, C, D parameter. Step 3. A, B, C, D parameter lah. Yang ni eh. So yang ni kena tengok lah. So A, B, C, D. So cari A, B, C, D ni. Yang lain semua sama. Beza kat situ saja. A, B, C, D saja. Nak cari A, B, C, D yang problem. Okay. So ada soalan tak? Saya rasa saya berhenti kat sini dululah. Awak buat dulu. Nanti ada masalah baru tanya. Sambung besok. Ada soalan tak? So siapa ni ya? Wezin Po, ada tak awak ke sana? Oh tak ada. So siapa yang ada ni? Awak ada? Awak ada soalan tak?
Ada soalan ke? Okey.
Semua okey ya?
Okey okey.
Kau you buat dulu. Sebab kalau you tak buat, you tak tahu. Ini memang problem ni. Long ni memang student banyak buat mistake lah. So, yang kena ingat tadi, macam mana kita nak solvekan saya padam lah. Saya padam lah. So, kena ingat tadi ya. Dua perkara yang you biasa tak boleh solve. Satu, square root of complex number. Yang ni memang error lah. Siapa-siapa yang tak pernah tengok video ataupun dia tak belajar, memang tak boleh solve. Square root of complex number, bila kita nak guna yang ni, kita nak cari Z. Punca kuasa 2, Z over Y. So you takkan dapat solve yang ni. So kita guna tadi, teorem Dimoy tu. Tak silap saya lah, saya tak ingat nama dia. Dimoyver ke? Dimoyver. Macam ni lah. So ni cara kita nak selesai. Satu, tak boleh selesai complex number, kita guna teorem ni. Yang kedua adalah masa nak kira cos hyperbolic tu L ni, sebenarnya dia adalah dalam gradient mode. So kita dah ada L sama dengan alpha plus J beta. Okay, semua ni adalah dalam gradient. So just tukar ke dalam gradient mode, kita punya calculator. Then kita baru-baru boleh calculate cos dan sin hyperbolic lah. Okay, bila dapat dua ni, yang lain tu just follow equation saja. Trick dia kat sini saja. Okay, kalau you boleh buat benda ni, saya rasa tak ada masalah lah. The rest sama dengan short dan juga medium. So contohnya, so tadi, okay, ni ya, saya padam. Hai, kita padam. Padam. Okay. Mana ya? Hai. So ada soalan tak? Saya tak ada apa nak share lah. Saya rasa tu je trick dia. Long ni dia tak susah pun. Yang susah cari A, B, C, D ya. Once you dapat A, B, C, D parameter, the rest is same as short and medium. Okay. So saya dah bagi tadi trick dia kat mana. So kalau you buat, nanti tak dapat, besok kita bincang balik lah. Okay. So ada soalan nak sebelum kita tamat? Dah lambat sangat dah ni.
So saya dekat nak masuk nilai cosh. Cari cosh dengan sin H tu je yang tukar kepada radian ni sir. Tu saja eh.
Ah, betul.
Yang
cosh kan?
A and B ha.
Maksudnya
itu saja.
Tukar radian. Alpha, cos, beta kan?
Ni itu saja.
Asal ni dalam red. Radian lah.
Okay.
So dalam red, okay. Nanti you akan dapat tambah J ni. Ini senang A kan? Ini senang cari A ni. J sin kan?
Aha.
Alpha, sin, beta ni lah. Ini semua dalam red. Nanti you akan dapat nilai macam ni. Contoh-contoh biasa 0.9 something lah nilai dia. 0.99 angle. Angle ni dalam red ni. So daripada mode radian ni awak tukar balik kepada mode degree lah. Kita tulis mode degree macam ni kita DEG lah, you tukar balik, you akan terus dapat 0.99 dengan angle 0 point something lah biasanya. Tengoklah dia dapat berapa, dia terus bagi nilai ni instead of bagi 5.5 tadi mili apa ni 5.5 mili radian tadi, tukar je mode degree, dia terus bagi nilai ni, ambil nilai ni as a final answer untuk A ni.
Okay sir, okay.
So final answer untuk ni semua dalam degree balik eh. Ni semua dalam degree balik. Untuk kira A saja tadi. Ni dalam untuk degree dah. Nanti nak kira V kan, VS kan. IS. Ini semua degree ni. A angle apa degree ya kat sini kan. VR kan. Ini dah dalam degree lah. Mesti dalam degree, jangan simpan dalam rek. Salah nanti. So kena tukar siap-siap dalam degree macam ni. SPIR. Ni pun dalam degree lah. Sampai sini dah degree. Radian untuk cari ABCD je. Okay. Dah dapat okay. Okay. Tukar balik dalam mode degree lah. Okay. Lalu so, besok sambung balik lah. Ada soalan lain?
Sir. Sir. Yeah. Kira ZC dengan gamma dalam radian juga ke?
ZC?
Kira ZC dengan gamma?
Tak payah. ZC nanti awak kira dalam mode biasa je.
Okay.
Dalam mode degree tadi. Dalam degree lagi. ZC dengan ni gamma kan? Ini degree. Tapi sebenarnya ini adalah nilai ni, bila kira ni adalah dia bagi dalam red lah. Nilai ni kita kena guna dalam mode radian nanti. Ni alpha plus J beta ni. Ni semua ni red lah. Ini memang dia dah kira dalam red. Walaupun kita kira dalam degree kat sini tadi kan. Ni degree kan. Nilai ni bila kita nak kira cos, ini adalah nilai radian. Faham tak?
Okay. Faham. Terima kasih.
Soalan lain tak? Ada soalan lain? Ada yang dah buat soalan mana-mana ke? Tak dapat jawapan nak discuss? Perlu besok kita bincang lah. Okay. So yang ni tadi, kalau awak pergi kat dalam kalam, nota ni ada dalam kalam. Dia dah bagi dah jawapan ni. Awak cuba buat. Dapat tak VS sama dengan yang ni? VS, IS. Power factor. Ni power factor. Dia ada power factor. Power factor awak try lah cari macam mana power factor. Okay. Dia dah bagi semua. Awak cuba dulu. Okay. Awak boleh bincang besok. Okay. Ada soalan lain tak? Kalau tak ada, kita habis kat sini. Dah lewat sangat. So besok sambung balik lah dalam besok kelas saya jam berapa lah? Kelas. Ada student section 3 lah kat sini. Besok kelas saya jam 2 tak salah saya. Jam 2 petang. Siapa-siapa nak join boleh lah besok.
Betul, sir.
You ada kelas tak? Besok? Ada kan? Dah habis?
Ada.
Ha? Ada?
Kelas kita lah, seksyen 3.
Kenapa kelas 3? So yang seksyen 2 boleh lah, siapa-siapa nak join? Esok last kelas kot, sebelum test. Hari Rabu kita tak ada kelas. Test Rabu malam kan?
Betul, sir.
Okay, alright. So thank you for joining this class. So kita jumpa lagi besok. Alright.
Terima kasih, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Alright.